Hello, I'm Tom Dozier, and this video is on preventing new misophonia triggers. You probably already have more triggers than you want. You don't want any more, so let's figure out how to not get any more misophonia triggers. First, I want to talk about the difference between misophonia getting upset from a misophonia trigger and getting upset from sounds because you're a highly sensitive person. Because this video is going to deal with misophonia triggers. Now, a highly sensitive person is disrupted, bothered, upset because of sounds that are intrusive into their world. They're typically slow to respond to the sound, but once it keeps happening, it makes them more and more upset. It's these invasive sounds, such as airplanes continually flying over, or traffic noise, or dogs that bark a lot, or loud talking of other people. There's not really the same physical reflex like you have with misophonia, and again, you don't trigger to the first car that drives by. You trigger when the cars start driving by and you see what time it is, and then you know it's going to be going on all day, and then that really upsets you. So that's a highly sensitive person. With misophonia, you have an instant response. It feels like you're being slapped or poked or shocked or zapped some way, popped with a rubber band. You know, you hear other sounds, but you feel the misophonia trigger. The trigger is just, ugh, feel it differently. In fact, in the 95% of the people I've worked with or so, I've seen that we can identify a physical reflex that the person has. Now, you probably won't know your physical reflex, but if you kind of like a ooh when you feel that sound, that is because of the physical reflex. So how do we prevent new triggers? Well, the first way that triggers spread is they spread like an infectious disease. So if I kiss my grandkids who have a cold and then I kiss my wife, well, my wife ends up with a cold, right? Because they come in contact with me, I come in contact with my wife. So if I have a trigger sound and it comes in contact with some other sound, then I go away with two trigger sounds. So some examples of that would be if you triggered a crunching, and then while you're sitting at the dinner table being triggered, you start noticing that the people are a little harsh with some of their forks on the plate, the clicking. Well, that clicking can become a trigger sound. You may trigger to the crunching at first, but you're also noticing that the person's sniffing, you know, at dinner table, and now you go away with a crunching and a sniffing trigger. You trigger to the crunching of one person, but then you start noticing the other people at the table, and then you trigger to everyone there, and then you start triggering to everyone in the world. So trigger sound comes together with a non-trigger sound, you go away with two trigger sounds. The same thing's true with a visual trigger. Misophonia almost always starts with an auditory trigger, but any visual repeating image while you're hearing it being triggered, you go away with a visual trigger. For example, gum chewing, you trigger to the popping sound of the gum, and then you see their jaw moving, and you trigger to the jaw moving. And once you start triggering to that visual trigger, it's an independent trigger. You could get rid of the trigger of the sound of gum popping, and you'd still trigger to the visual. In fact, people notice that you're driving and you see somebody in another car. You can't hear a single sound, but you trigger to that visual of them moving their jaw. So you want to avoid triggers. If you stay in a triggering situation, you're setting yourself up to get a new trigger. Yeah, and if you can't avoid, sometimes you can minimize your response. And the way you can minimize your response is you can reduce that trigger reflex by using background noise. A box fan, noise machines, headphones, little behind-the-ear sound generators, all of those are great for reducing the response, because if you can reduce the response, then you're far less likely to pick up another sound as a trigger, because you won't be so emotionally distressed and distraught over the triggering. You can also reduce your emotional response. View the trigger as a physical reflex. Oh, that's your little lizard brain nipping at you. It's not the other person attacking you. There's been a case study with cognitive behavior therapy where the person was able to deal with this in a calm way and move on with their life and have the misophonia be, they don't like it, it's irritating, but it got rid of all the emotional upheaval. And if you could do that, then you shouldn't be picking up new triggers. And then muscle relaxation can help to relax instantly after being triggered to control that emotional upheaval that comes from the misophonia trigger. Well, what do you do when there's a trigger, right? As I said, you don't want to hear triggers, so you need to be free to leave. So parents with kids with misophonia, they need to be free to get up and move away from the dinner table without you going, oh, again? Because if you're going to huff or puff or complain, they're not really free to leave. So they need to be free to move away from the trigger. We need to avoid and escape the triggers, because tolerating the triggers will only make it worse. If you have misophonia, it's up to you to protect yourself. You know when you're being triggered. You don't have to be screaming or yelling or complaining to be sitting there getting triggered. And you know when you're being triggered, so move away from it. A great tool is the Bose QC20 or 20i noise-canceling headphones. They are wonderful at blocking out the trigger sounds so that you can be in the situation with a little music or a little background noise or white noise with those headphones on with their noise canceling mode and get rid of the triggers. There are a few reflexes that you can block. For example, if you're having a esophagus constriction, you can swallow to just kill that reflex. Sometimes with specific muscles, you can just relax that muscle. But that's generally rare that you can do that. But you need to take good care of yourself. You get sleep, diet, exercise, the things that help your mood. The better you're feeling, the less your misophonia is going to impact you and the less likely you are to pick up new triggers. Now there's a second way that you can get a new trigger, and it's the way you got your first trigger. And it's pairing this distressed situation of feeling all distressed with a repeating sound. And this is a way that this is for non-triggers, but so to keep from having that distressed and hearing that irritating sound that bugs you, just think of the world around you as a noisy place. It's not a personal attack on you, it's just environmental noise. It's life going on around you. Those noises are positive to someone or something. So just try to put a positive spin on it. Try to relax about it. You know, a good example, my wife didn't get misophonia from this, but she could have, is I use this electric toothbrush. I've been using it for 20 years. And my wife would beat me to bed, and here I am in the bathroom going, and she has trouble relaxing and chilling out and going to sleep. And so she's trying to read and goes, oh, Tom's in there with that toothbrush. That's so annoying. Why does he have to use that stupid toothbrush? Well, she's in there going, and that's just the situation. She could have picked up a trigger, but she didn't, luckily. Well, one day she said, you know what, Pam? It's just an electric toothbrush. And people use electric toothbrushes. So if Tom wants to use an electric toothbrush, he has every right to. After that, it never bothered her when she was in the bed and I started brushing my teeth. So there's something about putting a positive spin on these sounds that you can let them go. And as I mentioned, there's something positive about a lot of these sounds to someone else. Think about it for them. Distract yourself, sing a song, say a poem, squeeze an object, focus on wiggling your toes or something. But get your mind off of the sound by doing something else. Relax your muscles. And if you can't relax or ignore it, then you have to just escape. Get away from it. Because distress plus a repeating sound is a way that you generate misophonia. And you don't want to do that. And I know people from my work where they would have, for example, a jaw clench for eating sounds and a shoulder clench for typing sounds. And that means that they had developed misophonia twice. Most people don't. Most people only develop it once, and then they pick up the pairing of the two sounds to go away with two triggers. So take good care of yourself. So my conclusion is just what I said. Take good care of yourself. Take charge of your trigger sounds. Don't let them take charge of you. And don't feel that you have to stay and tolerate a trigger sound, because if you stay and tolerate it, then you're liable to go away with a new trigger sound, and you don't want to do that. So thank you for watching this video. I'm Tom Dozier. If it's been beneficial to you, would appreciate a donation to the Misophonia Treatment Institute. We'll use those funds for education, misophonia awareness, research, and to develop new treatments. Thank you very much.